Hi, good morning students. In the last class we were discussing about applications of linear equations, that is step results. Alright, in the exercise 2.2. I was explaining you the odd number sums. I told you even number sums you have to solve as a homework. I hope you have done those and you don't have any doubt. Okay, so if you have doubt, just you round up in the pencil the question number which you have doubt, so you can clarify those. Now come to this, the question number 9 till question number 7 I explained you in the last class. Now the question number 9. The ages of Robin and Harun are in the ratio of 5:7. 4 years later, the sum of their ages will be 56 years. What are their present ages? Okay. The ages of Robin and Harun. Question number 11. Baijiu's father is 26 years younger
older than Baichu's grandfather and 22 years older than Baichu. So the sum of their ages for all the other children is 145 years. So what we will do? The question number 11. Let the Baichu's age be X years. His father's age becomes what? Is 29 years older than Baichu. So as a result of that, father's age is equal to X plus 29 years. So Baichu's father is 26 years older than the Baichu's grandfather. As a result of that, his grandfather father's age becomes what? X plus 29 plus years. X plus 29 plus 26 years. I hope you follow. Sum of these three ages is equal to 135 years. So as a result of that, the sum of their ages is 135 years. But X, how do I write? So Baichu is X, and his father is X plus 29, and his grandfather says X plus 29 plus 26. So 9 plus 6 is what? 15. 1 carry, 2 plus 2 plus 1, 55. So which is equal to 135. Now open this bracket, X plus 29 plus X plus 55 is equal to 135. So x and x is 3x plus 9 plus 5 is 14, 1 carry, 2 plus 5, 7, 1 carry is 8, 84 is equal to 145. Now shift the side. 3x is equal to 135 minus 84. What you will get? 3x is equal to 5 minus 4 is 1 and 13 minus 8 is 5. So x is equal to what? 51 divided by 3. Therefore x is equal to 17. Therefore y is equal to 17 years. Y is father age is equal to x plus 29, that is equal to 17 plus 29, 9 plus 7 is 16, carry, so 46 years. And by choose grandfather's age, grandfather's age is equal to x plus 55, so that is 17 plus 55, 5 plus 7 is 12, 1 carry, 5 plus 1 is 6, 1 is 7, 2 years. So that the Baichu's age is 17 years and his father age is 46 years and grandfather age is 72 years. That will be followed. Okay, so writing this statement is important. Baichu's age I took as X years. So his father age becomes X plus 29 as he is 29 years older than Baichu. So X plus 29 and his age is 26 years younger than his father. As a result of that, x plus 29 plus 26 we have to take for grandfather's age. So as a result of that, we will get the sum of their ages is 135 years is given. So sum of three ages, that is Baichu's father, Baichu's grandfather is 135. When you open the bracket and add, you will get this much. So x is equal to 323 gives you 17 years. As a result of that, Baichu's age becomes 17 years. Father age becomes 17 plus 29, 46 years, and grandfather's age becomes equal to 17 plus 55, that will give you 72 years. I hope you follow. Next comes the question number 15. So practice this by writing the data repeatedly so that you will be able to solve by yourself. result of that, the question number 50. I have a total of rupees 308 points denomination of rupees 1, rupees 2 and rupees 5. The number of 2 points is 3 times the number of 5 points. Since the total number of points is 160, how many points of each denomination are with me? Since it is given 2 points is 3 times the number of 5 points, we will take 5 points as x. So question number 50. Let the number of rupees 5. So I write like this. Rupees 5 coin is equal to x. The number of rupees 2 coin is equal to 3 times that of rupees 5 coin. So 3x. The total number of coins are 160. As the result of that, the number of 1 rupee coin is 1 coin is equal to 160 minus x minus 3x. Right? So that will be 160 minus 4x. I hope you follow. Now, some of this constitutes what? This 1, this 2, and this 5 constitute 300 rupees. As a result of that, 160 minus 4x plus 3x, that is 2 into 3x. Okay, plus 5 into rupees number of 5 problems is x. So 5x, which is equal to 300. 5 more into this is 2 into 1. As a result of that. Okay, this is 1 into 1 into 1 into 1 into 1. Okay, so over the bracket, 160 minus 4x plus 2 pizza is 6x. Plus 5x is equal to 300. Now 6 plus 5 is 11. 11 minus 4 is 7x. So 160 minus 7x is equal to 300. Okay. Minus 7x that side becomes plus. Right. So 160 minus plus 7x. So 7x that it will be there only. No sign. 160 that side. 7x is equal to 300 minus 160 will give you what? 140. So as a result of that, x is equal to what? 140 divided by 7. So x is equal to 7 choose 40 and 90. So therefore, x is 20. It becomes number of 5 points is equal to 20. So number of 250 point, which 2 point is equal to 2 into 3x. So that is 2 3s are 6x, 6 into 20. Sorry, this is number of 250 point is 3x already we have here. So by 3x, so 3 into 20 will gives you 60 points. So next, number of rupees 1 point is equal to 160 minus 4x. 160 minus 4x. So that will give you what? 160 minus 4 into x is 28. So 160 minus 80 will give you what? 80. So therefore, the number of 150 coins is equal to what? 80 numbers. Number of 150 coins is 60 and number of 550 coins is equal to 20. So as a result of that, 25 is 100, 62 is 120 and 80. 120 and 80 is 200. 200 plus 100 gives you 300. So got it? I hope you followed. So once again you see, let the number of rupees 5 coin be x. The number of rupees 2 coin becomes what? 3x. And number of rupees 1 coin is equal to 160 minus x minus 3x. Eliminate. Rupees 5 and rupees 3 out of 160. So that number of 150 coin will be. So sum of all these three coins is constitutes what? Rupees 300. Okay. So 1 rupee, 2 rupee, and 5 rupee. Open the bracket. You will get this one. 7 is equal to 140. X is equal to 140 divided by 7. Therefore, x is equal to 20. So we got rupees 5. The number of coins is equal to 20. So number of holding points is 3x. So that 3 into 20 will give you 60, and number of holding points is equal to 160 minus 4x. 4 into x is 20, will give you 80. So 160 minus 80 becomes what? 80. So I hope you followed. So the I solved 15th question as a result of that. Had number sums completed. So remind you number sums. You have to practice as HLE. Okay, practice repeatedly so that you will be able to understand more properly. I hope you follow whatever I explained so far. We will see you next in the next class. Thank you.